Dear students, we shall go to the next topic in module 5, draft tube and unit quantities. Here there will be no problem. We have to cover only the theoretical aspects of draft tube as well as the unit quantities now. Now this is the syllabus. We have covered all these portions up to today. Now we are in this class, we will be going ahead with the draft tube and unit quantities. Now we have already discussed about the draft tube in detail in the previous classes. However, the theory behind it is not being discussed now. So we will, in detail, we will discuss here now. So draft tube is nothing but, it is a enlarged tube which is connected at the runner exit to the tail race, runner exit of the turbine to the tail race, where the water is finally discharged to the river proper. Now the hydraulic, this is one of the important component of a hydraulic turbine, especially in the case of reaction turbine, whereas in impulse turbine we are not going to provide the tail race, the draft tube. Now, as you know, in impulse turbine the energy, all the energy will be converted into kinetic energy before it is impacting into the buckets. Whereas in the case of reaction turbine, the water from the penstock will be entering, having both flow energy, the kinetic energy as well as the pressure energy. Whereas in the case of impulse turbine, when the jet hits the bucket, all the kinetic energy would have been converted by the jet itself now. So the impulse of the jet is converting the kinetic energy into mechanical energy in the case of impulse turbine. Whereas in the case of reaction turbine, here part of the energy will be in pressure energy, part of the energy will be kinetic energy before it is entering into the turbine proper. Therefore, the pressure energy will be maximum at the inlet and it goes on reducing, and almost it will become zero. It will become zero at the end of the turbine proper. Like that, if the turbine is properly designed, the pressure energy will be zero at the exit of the turbine. And it may become negative also now. The primary function of the draft tube, therefore, is to see that the amount of kinetic energy which is not being converted will be converted further into pressure energy by means of reducing the kinetic energy at the exit of the draft tube to a minimum, and hence improve the pressure energy at the exit of the turbine. So the primary function of the draft tube is to reduce the velocity. That means the kinetic energy will be get reduced by provision of a tube at the exit. The velocity of that one will be minimized at the exit, and hence the kinetic energy will be made, almost it should be made equal to zero, we say now. It may not happen now, whereas the pressure energy will increase now. So this, by doing this, it is possible for us to set the turbine above the tail race without any appreciable draft drop of official appreciable drop of available head. That is very important, because the available head itself is very much less in the case of reaction turbine now. So as much we are told that 10 to 70 meter in the case of Keplon turbine now. So if at all, if the height, if the head available is only 10 meter, then if we lose say 1 or 2 meter, it is a very great loss. It is very great loss. That is important now. We have to utilize maximum head which is available for the reaction turbine. So that is possible by means of provision of this draft tube now. So therefore, the draft tube helps to see that the turbine can be set up little above the tail water level without any appreciable loss of the available head now. In an impulse turbine, the available head, as you know, it is very high now. It is very high. Impulse turbine is the high head turbine now. Even if you, if some 2 or 3 meter is being get lost because of provision of, because of some reasons, there is no significant effect on the efficiency now. So because the available head is considerably high. But in the case of reaction turbine, if the net head is low, if the turbine is installed above the tail rays, there can be appreciable loss of pressure head. That's what I told. If the head available is say 10 meter, 10 to 15 meter, if the tail rays, if the turbine is to be placed say about 2 or 3 meter above the tail rays, then there is a loss of 2 or 3 meter, say about 15 meter, 3 meter if it was, means 12 meter. So it is a very great loss now. So that loss, what is going to happen, will be taken care of by means of the draft tube now. So since most of the pressure energy of water in the reaction turbine, as I've already told you, is converted into mechanical energy. The pressure energy at the end of turbine is almost equal to zero. And hence, all the energy, pressure energy, will be converted into mechanical energy, means what? Shaft power. It will become shaft power. Mechanical energy means shaft power. That is nothing but the rotation. It is going to convert it into rotational energy. Mechanical energy means rotational energy. Hence, the pressure at the exit of the turbine is below the atmospheric. Almost all the head will be converted, and hence it is below the atmospheric. Theoretically speaking, it will be less than zero also now. It will be less than atmospheric pressure now. And hence, if at all, if it becomes less than atmosphere at the exit of the turbine, what is going to happen now? The water, if you are having a turbine here now, if it is less than atmospheric pressure, then water from the tail race, this is the tail race if you are having, water from the tail race will start backflowing, because it is suction pressure. Less than atmospheric means it is suction pressure or negative pressure. Negative pressure or suction pressure. So if negative pressure is, because all the pressure is converted into rotational energy or mechanical energy in the case of reaction turbine, because at the entrance you will be having maximum pressure head. Maximum pressure head will be there now. But at the exit, it will become less than atmospheric now. So at the entry, you will be having maximum kinetic energy as well as maximum pressure energy now. So kinetic energy as well as pressure energy will be get converted. Pressure head will become less than zero, whereas the kinetic energy will be having a little kinetic energy may be there, which is not being converted into pressure energy. So at this point, at the exit of the turbine, at the exit of the turbine, you will be having only some kinetic energy will be there. Very little kinetic energy will be there. So this little kinetic energy, what we are saying, shall also be converted into pressure energy so that it should be useful for the reaction turbine for the rotation now. Otherwise, if it becomes negative now, what will happen now? If the pressure becomes negative, the water from the river, that is nothing but the tail race, will flow back to the reaction turbine and it may damage the plates of the reaction turbines also now. So, if the pressure of the water at the exit of the turbine is less than atmospheric pressure, then it will cause black flow of water from the tail race, which is at atmospheric pressure, to the turbine and can create significant damage to the reaction turbine. Therefore, we have to provide the draft tube and see that the velocity energy what is there is to be minimum here. There will be certain velocity now by means of providing the divergent tube. Divergent tube, for example, if V1 is the velocity here, when it flows from this tube, if it becomes V2, V2 is less than V1, then naturally the kinetic energy will be get reduced, the potential, the pressure energy will be get increased, and hence that can be utilized from the turbine and the backflow can be minimized now. So two functions here. So by placing the diffusing pipe, that is the enlarged pipe, at the exit of the runner, the pressure head is increased. The pressure head at the exit of the turbine is being increased by decreasing the exit velocity, and both overall efficiency and the output of the turbine is improved. That is the importance. Okay. So the purpose of providing draft tube will be better understood by means of the theory now. So now, what is the theory of the draft tube now? Theory of draft. We have to understand what is the theory behind the draft tube. Theory of draft. The effective head across the turbine, as I've already told you, if you are considering a turbine now, if you are considering a turbine now, the effective head across the turbine, is the difference in the head between the inlet to the machine and the outlet from it. That is, this is the inlet, this is the outlet now. So what is this effective head? This is the, what is the loss that has happened? What is that? It is being utilized now. Okay. The kinetic energy of the fluid is finally discharged into the tail race is wasted. That means if at all, if there is certain kinetic energy, it is a waste. It will become waste. I don't want to waste this kinetic energy. Okay. The kinetic energy of the fluid finally discharged into the tail race is wasted. A draft tube is made divergent so as to reduce the velocity to the minimum. That means I am, by providing of the draft tube, I am reducing the velocity V2 to a minimum from V1. And therefore, the draft tube is a diffuser and should be designed properly with an angle generally at 8 degrees, 6 to 8 degrees, so as to prevent the flow separation. One is that the water may flow up. This is one thing. The second one is the cavitation may happen now. That means here the flow separation may happen. All the water, what is that we want to see, that in the case of reaction turbine, you know that completely the water is filled in the reaction turbine, as well as it should be in the draft tube. It should be filled completely now. Okay. So if it is not so, there may be some cavitation that may happen in the draft tube and may create flow separation and cavitation problem may happen now. So always the reaction turbine, completely the reaction turbine, that is the spiral casing as well as runner, the space provided for the runner and shaft, as well as the draft tube should be completely filled up with water in the case of reaction turbine now. Okay. So what is that here seeing now? If you are looking here now, this is the thing now. If this is the turbine casing now, I have already told you, this is the draft tube, is a draft tube, is nothing but a diverging tube now. Let's consider two points now. One is this is the inlet to the draft tube, this is the outlet to the draft tube now. Okay, so the water level should always be a little above. That means the draft tube should be in the draft tube exists shall be in the water at a depth of equal to y now. Okay, it should be always submerged. The draft tube should always be submerged in water. It cannot be exposed to the atmosphere now. Okay, so let's assume that it is y. The depth of is y underwater now. Let hs be the total height above the tail rest level to the inlet of the turbine now. Let P1 be the pressure at this point, P2 be the pressure at this point now. P2 be the pressure at this point, exit of the draft tube. PA is the atmospheric pressure, that you know because it is open to the, this is open to the atmosphere now. Okay. And V1 is the velocity at this point, V2 is the velocity at the exit of the draft tube now. Okay. Now, if you apply the Bernoulli's theorem, what you are saying? Pressure head plus velocity head plus the datum head at this point. That is nothing but P, pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head at 1,1 shall be equal to pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head at 2,2. This is our principle now. That is our Bernoulli's principle. Pressure head plus velocity head plus datum head at this point should be equal to pressure head plus velocity head plus datum head at the exit of this one now. That is the law of conservation of energy or Bernoulli's equation now. So as I've already told you, P1 is the pressure at the inlet of the draft tube, P2 is at the exit of the draft tube, and V1 is the velocity of fluid at the inlet of the draft tube, and V2 is the velocity at the exit of the draft tube, that is V2 now. And rho is the density of the fluid, that is nothing but the water now, acceleration due to gravity. HF is the head loss in the pipe now. So while it is flowing from this point to this point, there will be head loss, that is called as HF, that is the head loss of head in the draft tube now. HS is the vertical height above the tail rest level, this is HS. This is HS, and Y is the distance from the bottom of the tail rest, that is from the exit of the tail rest to the tail rest level, that is Y now. And PA is the atmospheric pressure, that's what we have told now. Now, if you want to apply the Bernoulli's theorem for this, I think it is there in the next figure also. Yes, if you want to apply the Bernoulli's theorem for this now. So here, the first point here is P1 by W plus V1 squared by 2G plus HS plus Y, that you are seeing now. Here only it is, the figure is there now. HS plus Y, P1 by W. I am taking this at the datum now. So P1 by W at this point, or W is equal to rho G, anyhow you know it now. V1 squared by 2G plus HS plus Y, that is the datum point for this now, is equal to P2 by W or P2 by rho G plus V2 squared by 2G plus 0 plus HF. HF is the head loss due to friction in the draft tube now. So that is HF now. Okay. So now, because why it is 0 now? Because we have taken this at the datum. This is the datum I have taken now. Okay. So, rearrange this, you will get this equation now. So, what is P2 by W? What is P2 by W? P2 by W is equal to PA by W. This is PA by W plus Y. Because I am going down plus Z. That is PA by W plus Z. That is R of Z is equal to Y here now. PA by W is equal to PA by rho G plus Y. Just substitute P2 by W is equal to PA by W plus rho g in this equation, PA by rho g plus y minus HS. I have taken this one minus HS minus y. I expanded this plus V2 squared by 2g plus minus V1 squared by 2g plus HF. All these equations is being written now. So this y and this y will be get cancelled. I will be left with PA by rho g minus HS plus V2 squared by 2g minus V1 squared by 2g plus HF now. I rearrange this equation by taking negative on both sides now, on this, this one now. So I will write V1 squared by 2g minus V2 squared by 2g, that I can write it, and I can write like this now. So P1 by rho g, that is left hand side is like that only. Right hand side what I have written, PA by rho g, I have kept like that only. PA by rho g, I have kept like that only now. And I have taken negative outside now. Minus of V1 squared by 2g, minus V2 squared by 2g, minus HF. Just I have taken this equation. This one minus I have taken outside. It will become what? Minus V1 squared by 2g plus V2 squared by 2g. Minus V2 squared by 2g. Because minus of minus plus it will become. Minus HF it will become now. Minus HS I have kept like this only. For this portion I have taken negative outside, then what you will get now, minus of, first I will write V1 squared by 2g, this expression minus of plus minus it will become, then minus of V2 squared by 2g, that will become plus minus HF. I will write it now, this HS I will keep it like this now, the same thing I have written here now, just look into it now. So what is this V1 squared by 2g minus V2 squared by 2g minus HF? That is nothing but kinetic head. That is called as the kinetic head. Okay. So here if you neglect HF, it will become V1 squared by 2g minus V2 squared by 2g is also called as kinetic head now. So from this expression, what you can see now? This is atmospheric pressure now. I am deducting this one. I am deducting this one in this portion now. That means P1 by rho g. What is P1 by rho g? What is P1 by rho g? P1 by rho g is nothing but pressure head. Pressure head at inlet. At inlet of draft. Right? Pressure head at inlet of draft. I am reduced. That value is less than the atmospheric pressure. This is PA by rho g. I am deducting this portion. I am deducting this quantity also. Therefore, the pressure head at the entrance is less than atmospheric. So that should be there. What is this pressure head at the inlet of draft tube is nothing but it is also equal to pressure head at the exit of turbine runner. Therefore, all the pressure energy, if it is an ideal turbine, all the pressure energy at the reaction, at the end of reaction turbine is being converted and it has become negative already. It is less than atmospheric. Therefore, there is every chance that the water may move from the tail race towards the draft tube, towards the runner now. This is the runner or the reaction turbine now. This is the reaction turbine now. So, pressure head at the inlet of the draft tube or outlet of the turbine is less than the atmospheric pressure. So, the net head on the turbine on the draft tube is, with draft tube is increased now. Okay. So, that means, so the net head on the turbine with the draft tube is increased by provision of the draft tube now, right? So the efficiency of the draft tube, again I am telling you very important point now, pressure head at the inlet of the draft tube or outlet of the draft tube is less than the atmospheric pressure, so the net head on the turbine with the draft tube is increased. How do you increase it now? By provision of the draft tube, the velocity energy will be converted into kinetic energy now. This is being converted now. It is being converted now. Okay. So, now, the efficiency drop to, what is the efficiency of the drop to? Actual conversion of the kinetic energy into present energy, that is nothing but V1 squared by 2G minus V2 squared by 2G minus HF divided by the input. This is the output. At the output, that is nothing but the work done. It is nothing but the work done. What is that? It is converted in nothing but the work done by the draft tube now. Actual conversion of kinetic head into pressure head. That is the work done by the draft tube divided by the input. Input is equal to V1 squared by 2G. That is the input energy what is there at the entrance. So this is the input energy V1 squared by 2G that I am converting it into kinetic energy now. So V1 squared by 2G is the input energy at the entrance that will be converted into V1 squared by 2G minus V2 squared by 2G minus HF. That's what we are doing it now. Okay. So that should be properly noted. That is, the velocity at this point is V1. The velocity at this point is V2 now. So the total energy that is converted is V1 squared by 2G minus V2 squared by 2G minus HF. That is the energy that is being converted by the draft because this is being reduced. V2 squared by 2G, that is the kinetic energy at the exit. And the loss that is being converted and V1 squared by 2G is the entrance. That is called as the efficiency. So HS is the vertical height of the draft tube. This is HS now, minus HF. Okay. So the efficiency of the draft tube is V1 squared by 2G minus V2 squared by 2G minus HF divided by V1 squared by 2G now. Actual conversion of the pressure head is this one. Okay. Theoretical conversion is, of course, if you neglect the loss due to friction because the length is very much less. If you neglect that, theoretical conversion is equal to V1 squared by 2G minus of V2 squared by 2G. Okay. So, this is our theory now. So, what is the purpose of draft tube? You know it now. Very important. The purpose of the draft tube, two things I have told you. Again, you should understand. That is, by diffusing, by provision of diffusing pipe at the exit of the runner, the pressure head is increased by decreasing the exit velocity. This is the important. The pressure head is decreased. The pressure head is decreased by provision of the, by increasing the, by decreasing the velocity. Okay. So that is one thing. The second thing that I told you is, if at all, if it becomes atmospheric, less than atmospheric, there is every chance that the backflow is going to happen. That backflow is being avoided by provision of the draft tube. This is second thing. The third purpose, what we told is, the third purpose, it is possible for the turbine to set up above the tail race without any appreciable drop of the available head. This is the second thing now. By providing the draft tube, it is possible for the turbine to set up above the tail race without appreciable drop of the available head because the available head is very much less. These three things should be properly known to you now. Now there are four different types of draft tubes. Now very simple draft tube is conical type of straight conical type of concentric tube and simple elbow type of draft tube. Next is elbow type of circular inlet with rectangular outlet draft tube. Moody's spreading draft tube. These are the various type of draft tube that are there now. If properly designed, generally the efficiency goes from 60% to 85%. But if properly designed, as it is being written here, it is goes up to 85% now, the efficiency of that one now. So what is efficiency? I have already told you now. So this type of turbine. This type of conical type of draft tube is provided for. It is a straight divergent type of draft tube. If the head available is here, you can see now this type of generally used for low powered units. Now, low powered unit for all specific speed, frequently for large head units. Generally, if the head available is large, that too in reaction turbine, if the available head is large, so it is not I am talking about 10 to 15 meter. If the available head is large, yes, this type of draft tube is provided. If that this type of, even for Francis turbine, this type of draft tube can be provided. So even for Francis, in the class I have shown you divergent with the elbow type, what I will show you in the next anyhow. Anyhow, we don't want to lose any energy. Therefore, however, this type of draft tube is a very simple type of conical draft tube provided when large head is available. Generally, as I told you, the divergence will be 4 to 6 degree, we say up to 8 degree it will be there now. The length will be 3 to 4 times the diameter. The length of this one is 3 to 4 times the diameter, and the discharge area is 4 to 5 times the throat area. That means this area and this area 4 times, 4 to 5 times it will be there. This is, if this is the 4A, this will be A, generally about 4 to 5 times area will be there now. So the diameter will be 3 to 4 times, the length will be 3 to 4 times the diameter will be there now. Okay. Whereas the elbow type of draft tube, you can see here now, elbow type of draft tube here, the water level is somewhere here, you can have. The water level can be here now. So in the elbow type of draft tube, it is just like an elbow of the water pipe or anything. Of course, it is a larger diameter. So now, generally it is used for when the turbine has to be placed close to the tail race. That means if the depth available is very much less now, if the depth available from the runner to the tail race is very, very less, because in the case of 10 to 15 meter, as I have already told, I don't want to lose any energy, means I may have to submerge so much. So you may have about 1 to 1.5 meter, that may be the case, then this type of draft tube is to be provided now. It helps to cut down the cost of excavation, and exit diameter should be as large as possible, because the velocity should become as minimum as possible. The kinetic energy is to be converted to a large extent. Therefore, the diameter should be as large as possible. The outer diameter should be as large as possible. The exit diameter should be as large as possible to recover the kinetic energy. Efficiency, because the head available itself is less, the efficiency will be about 60%. Generally, because the head available from the tail race to the runner exit is very much less, so the efficiency will be about 60% now. Whereas the elbow type of draft tube now. So this elbow type of draft tube, along with the rectangular exit now, it is a circular input, rectangular exit. At this point, it will be converted into circular to rectangular now. Okay. So that is there, if it is so now. Okay. This type of draft tube is designed to turn the water from vertical to horizontal direction. That is important now. So it is so designed that the water will change its direction from vertical to horizontal direction now. Okay. In a minimum depth of, and no excavation. Excavation is not essential, because excavation cost itself is very much this one. There is possibility that the soil may also enter otherwise. Therefore, excavation should be as minimum as possible. In the case of reaction turbine, there should not be any excavation, we say now. Truly speaking, ideally speaking, there should not be any excavation directly. It should be led to the river bed proper now, right? A little above it, because river bed is here, means it should be submerged properly. Now, there should be no excavation for the tail race. That is our general requirement now. So now it is bent, number one, and it is bent in the upward direction. This is the second condition. Now it is bent, the horizontal leg is horizontal leg takes place from circular to rectangular at the transition. Now the horizontal portion of the draft tube is generally inclined upward to lead the water gradually to the level of the tail race and to prevent the entry of air from the exit to exit end. There should not be entry of air now, because it should be always under suction pressure. It should be always under submerged condition now. Okay, for that purpose it is being bent upward now. Okay, the exit of the draft tube is totally immersed in water. I have already told you. One or two vertical piers may also be provided. In order this here, when it is large, we may provide one or two piers also now, inside now. Okay. So that should be known to here now. The draft tube is used for low head. Once again, it is when the low head is available, we don't want to lose the energy, as well as I don't want to dig the tail race and place the draft tube, then this type of draft tubes are provided now. So generally the efficiency is also, once again, it is about 60% now. Now the next one is Modi's type of draft tube now. So Modi's is generally conical type of draft tube only, but when the water flows from the entrance towards exit, there is a possibility that the swirls is going to happen now. In order to reduce the swirls, this type of draft tubes are provided. Okay, it is a single entry, double exit. Single entry, double exit. That type of draft tube is called as Modi type of draft tube. The outlet of the draft tube is split into two sections in this form, and in this form of the draft tube now. Modi's draft tube is similar to a conical draft tube and is with a central core. The central core component that divides the outlet into two parts. Now there is one inlet and two exit. I have already told you the main aim of this type of draft tube is to reduce the swirling of motion of water is to be reduced, and to increase the efficiency to 80 plus, that is about 85, it will be 88%, it is told. So generally the efficiency of this type of draft tube is around 88%. As I have told you, as conical draft tubes are used in when the depth is available is large. Okay, even this one, Modi's, will also be provided when the depth available is large. When the depth available is very less, say about 10 to 15 meter, then the two other draft tube, that is the previous one, elbow type of draft tube is the answer now. Elbow type of draft tube with circular inlet and circular outlet, or elbow type of draft tube with circular inlet and rectangular outlets are provided when the head available. Because the depth availability is very much less, the efficiency of these type of draft tube is only 60%. Both the elbow type of draft tube is 60%, whereas Modi's type of draft tube or the conical type of draft tube is having more efficiency, 75. This is also 80%. This efficiency is also equal to 80 to 85% it runs now. Okay, if properly designed now. That is about the type of draft tube now. So there we stop discussion on the draft tube. Why draft tubes are provided? What are the different types of draft tube? Is the common question that will be asked. Purpose of draft tube, theory of draft tube, and we are having the types of draft tube. These three things, many questions have come. Try to look into it. Only three type of problems will be there now. One is, what is the necessity of draft tube? Okay. Second one is, theory, as I've already told you, theory of draft tube. And types of draft tubes. These are the three things that are being asked. Generally, necessity of draft tube and types of draft tubes are very much common. Theory of draft tube, the derivation part is not frequently asked. They are not frequently asked now. Okay, once it might only once it is asked now. So these two things you try to see it, because it is a theory questions. It is commonly it is being asked now. Now the next one is the unit quantities. Now, what is this unit quantities? So we want to, here we discuss the performance of the turbine now. How the turbine behaves for different heads, different speed is necessary to be assessed now. It is possible to assess the behavior of a particular turbine under varying condition and comparing the performance of the turbines of the same type but having different outputs speeds at different heads. It is necessary to assess the outputs, assess the efficiency of the turbine for different outputs and speed now. Now keeping efficiency constant, what is the speed and what is the head it should be there? That is also the necessity of our performance in order to assess. Under a known head, what is that? I am having so much of head. One head is available, say about 100 meter head is available now. So I want to compare which is the best type of turbine that I want to provide now. Okay, for different heads available. Now, for different heads available, the same turbine I want to compare for different outputs and speeds. Then the process is called as performance under unit head. What is this unit head? We shall discuss it now. Okay, we shall discuss what is unit head now. It is often necessary to predict the behavior of a turbine working under varying conditions now, and to facilitate the comparison between the performance of the turbines of the same type but having different output of the same type. Turbines of the same type, very important, having different outputs and speeds and working at different heads. These are the things now. So these are the varying parameters now. So which is most efficient that I want to analyze. Then these aspects are done conveniently expressing the test results what we have done in terms of unit quantities now. Okay. So in order to assess the performance or the behavior of the turbine of same type for different outputs and speed now. So that means I am having a turbine now. I want to work at different speed. N1, N2, N3. Like this now. So what will be the efficiency? How the efficiency will change? This is one thing may be there now. So what should be the head? What should be the head requirement to see that it should work in these speed? That is our requirement. Okay. What will be our output? Output is nothing but the efficiency. What will be our efficiency if the turbine works at a different speed? That may be our condition. Second thing is, I am having different heads. For different heads, what should be the efficiency? What will be the efficiency I want to understand? Then the answer for this is studying the performance of the turbine by using the unit quantities now. How it is, we will look into it now. So unit quantities, what is this now? Unit quantities of a turbine are certain quantities related to a turbine, which is obtained when the turbine operates at head is equal to 1 meter. Turbine, when the turbine operates at head is equal to 1 meter, what is the speed? At head is equal to 1 meter, what is the output? At head is equal to 1 meter, what is the discharge? We call it as QU. So I have kept head end efficiency constant. Now, head end efficiency constant, I am finding what is the speed, what is the Q. Okay, this is called as unit speed, this is called as unit discharge. Unit discharge now. So head end efficiency is being kept constant, and I am finding the speed as well as the discharge. Those quantities are called as the unit speed and unit discharge. From the output of the turbine corresponding to different working heads, it is possible to compute the output which would develop if the head is reduced to unity. Okay, if the head is reduced to unity, how much of efficiency that you will get? That is called as the efficiency at the unit speed now. So efficiency of a given turbine will remain unchanged if the velocity triangle under working head and under unit head are geometrically similar. That is important. The efficiency of a given turbine will remain unchanged if the velocity triangle under working head means what? At different head and at 1 meter head. Unit head means 1 meter. At different head means say 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter. I have worked the reaction turbine at 10 meter head, at 20 meter head, at 30 meter head now. I have also worked the turbine at 1 meter head. So if you draw the velocity triangle for these things, if they are similar, the efficiency of a given turbine will be remain unchanged. It will not be changed if the velocity triangles are constant now. That should be known to you now. So let's consider two velocity triangles. One is the Francis turbine. We know it already. The Francis turbine will have the absolute velocity, relative velocity, and the flow velocity. Absolute velocity, horizontal component is velocity of wheel. The velocity of flow is the vertical component of the absolute velocity. Vr is called as the relative velocity. Alpha is called as the guide blade angle. Theta is called as the runner blade angle. So this is for any head, say 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, maybe for different head now. And this is for 1 meter head. They are similar now. They are similar. It is of similar shape now. So it will not change. If it is working at the efficiency of a given turbine, the efficiency of a given turbine will remain unchanged. Will remain unchanged. That is important. Will remain unchanged if the velocity triangles, if these two velocity triangles are similar, then the efficiency is also same. For example, this is also working at 80% efficiency. Means definitely this will also be working at 80% efficiency. That means I am keeping efficiency also constant in this case now, when I am studying the unit quantities now. So with this triangle, what you will get now? So here it is U divided by VW should be equal to UU by VW. I am comparing these two triangles now. So, and I am saying that U divided by UU should be equal to VW divided by VW. That's what you will get now. Also, you are having U divided by VF1 is equal to UU divided by VFU. That's what we have told. This we call it as equation 1 now. So, we know the equation for the efficiency, that is the work done to energy input. It is nothing but the efficiency, work done to the input energy now. Input per unit head as well as for the working head now. This is for working head, this is for the unit head now. Unit head means h is equal to 1 meter, this h is equal to h meter. Okay, this is for I have written the efficiency equation VWU by G. This is the work done or shaft power divided by the water power. This is the input. Vf squared by 2g. This is the work done. Vwu by g divided by Vf squared by g. For the unit power, if you write Vwu uu divided by Vfu squared by 2g. Okay. So what you will get now? Vwu by g divided by Vf1 squared by 2g is equal to Vwu u divided by g divided by Vf1 squared by u divided by 2g. Because Vf will be constant now. Velocity of flow will be constant for at the inlet now. Vf1 and Vfu now. Okay. So for one discharge if I write now. So therefore, the above expression, the ratio of the useful energy to the wasted velocity energy are nothing but the is same under working head as well as the unit head condition. This is nothing but the efficiency, what we have written now. Okay, useful energy is nothing but the input, wasted energy, that is the work done now. So eta h is equal to eta hu is equal to Vwu by gh or Vwu u by g into 1. H is equal to 1 meter now. That you know it now. H is equal to 1 meter now. So what you will get now from this expression now? From this expression you will get Vw divided by Vwu. Vw divided by Vwu is equal to uu h divided by u. Uu into h divided by u. This g and this g will get cancelled. I will get uu into h divided by u. I can write Vw divided by Vwu is equal to uu by u. Okay. Uu by u from 1. From this expression, what I am getting now? Vw from 1, what I got now? Vw divided by Vwu. I transferred this one here now. Vw divided by Vwu is equal to u divided by uu. This u by uu, from this expression, if I substitute, I will get u by uu is equal to uu into h divided by u now. Or I can write from this equation u square by uu square. You just look into here now. U square divided by uu square is equal to h. That's what you will get now. U square by uu square, or uu square is equal to, or what you will get now, uu square is equal to u square by h, or uu is equal to u by root h. What is this? It is the uu is equal to u by root h that you will get now. And also you will get vfu square is equal to vf square by root h. The same procedure if you do it now. From this equation now. So Vfu is equal to Vf over root h you will get now. The same procedure what we have done here if you do it now. So but u is equal to pi dn by 60. Uu is equal to pi dn u by 60. That you know it now. So nu by n, if you divide one by other, what you will get? Nu by n is equal to uu by uu. But uu is equal to u by root h here now. So you will get nu is equal to n by root h. This is called as the unit speed. This is called as the unit speed now. Okay. Nu represents the speed of the turbine under unit head. It is called as the unit speed. Under unit head. Therefore it is called as the unit speed now. Similarly, we know that Q is equal to K into pi dB into Vf in the case of reaction turbine now. What is B and what is A? B is the width and D is the depth. We know it now. Pi dB into Vf, that is the discharge for discharge equation. For if at all if you are having unit discharge, that will become VFU now. So QU by Q, if you write for Q by 2, you will get VFU by VF. We already know what is the relationship between this one now. VF by VFU, VFU by VF is equal to 1 over root H. That we know it now. So from this equation, VFU by VF is equal to 1 by root H. That you know it now. So therefore, I can write, comparing these two things, I will write QU is equal to Q over root H. What is this QU? QU is called as unit discharge. Unit discharge. What is unit discharge? It is the discharge of a turbine. It is the discharge required for the turbine when it is running at 1 meter height. You know, 1 meter head. That head is always constant. In all these cases, 1 meter head now. So if I make this 1 meter head, what will happen? It is the discharge of the turbine when the turbine is working at 1 meter head now. Where QU represents the discharge flowing through the turbine under a unit head. All these things are at unit head only. This also at under unit head only. Okay. What we told is also, this one is also under unit head only. That should be noted. It is the speed of the turbine. It is the speed of the turbine. Unit speed means it is the speed of the turbine when the turbine is working at unit head. That's what we discussed, what we told, what we defined here now. Unit quantities of the turbine are certain quantities related to a turbine which are obtained when the turbine operates under unit head. Under unit head. That is very much important now. And also we are told that because we are comparing the two velocity triangles of different heads, one head and another head, it should be similar means what we have told now. We have told that the efficiency of that one remains unchanged. That means the efficiency is also constant in this case. The efficiency of the given turbine will remain unchanged if the velocity of the triangle under working head and under unit head are geometrically similar. Because we are comparing, when we are deriving this one, when we are deriving this one, we are comparing two velocity triangles, and because if these things ought to be similar, the efficiency should be constant, we are told now. So two conditions should be there. Now one is head is equal to constant 1 meter and efficiency is constant. These two things, when it is there, these things are we are defining now. Okay, that is N you know, P, Q you know now. Now we will go for unit power now. What is power now? Efficiency is equal to what? Efficiency is equal to shaft power, SHP divided by water power, P divided by WQH. That is called as the efficiency, that you know it now. So efficiency into WQH is equal to P now. Therefore P is directly proportional to Q, is directly proportional to Q into H now. Or Q is directly proportional to H. So what you will get now? What you will get now? Q is directly proportional to root H, that we know it already now. In the previous derivation, we've already got it now. Q is directly proportional to root H, we have got it. Therefore, what you will understand now, because Q is directly proportional to root H, you will get P is directly proportional to H to the power of 3 by 2. P is directly proportional to H by 2 because Q is directly proportional to root H. So that means I am writing here root H. If I write here root H, it will become H to the power of 3 by 2. In the previous expression, we are told that Q is directly proportional to root H now. So I can write, if I remove this proportionality sign, I will get P is equal to some constant K3 into H to the power of 3 by 2. This is a constant now. Okay. So when P becomes PU, H become 1. When P become PU, when this P becomes PU, H will become K3 into 1 to the power of 3 by 2 or 1 now. So what you will get now? Therefore, what you are going to know? PU is equal to K3. It will become PU is equal to K3 now. So what I can write now? P is equal to PU into H to the power of K3 is equal to PU now. PU into H to the power of 3 by 2. Or I can write PU is equal to P to the power of H to the power of 3 by 2. This is called as the unit power. Unit power. So what is this unit power now? Unit power says that it is the power generated by the turbine. Power generated by the turbine when working at 1 meter height. Once again, this has to become 1. Then only PU will become P. So whenever we want to define this one, it should be done like that. H is equal to 1 I have to make. It is the power generated by the turbine when the head on the turbine is equal to 1 meter. Very different. Definitions only they have asked now. Many times definitions they have asked. PU, KU, LU now. So this head is constant. That should be properly. Head is equal to 1 meter. That should be properly written. Otherwise the mass will not be given. PU is the power developed by the turbine when the head on the turbine is equal to 1 meter. Similarly, Q is the discharge required for the turbine for when the head is equal to 1 meter. NU is the speed of the turbine when that turbine is running at 1 meter head. Okay, that is what, that is the definitions now. So what is the advantage of obtaining the performance under unit head? Is that if you know the performance at unit head, at different discharges also you can obtain now. So that means unit head is that known for a discharge Q, N and P. The turbine working under head Q1, N1 and P1 corresponding to some other word H1 may be computed. The advantage of obtaining performance of unit head is that from a known value of Q, N and P, I know Q, N and P. For a known value of Q, N and P of a turbine working under working head, say H, working under H. So when the turbine is working under head H, this is the power generated, this is the speed it works, this is the Q that is required. If you know that one, then I can get Q1, N1 and P1, Q1, N1 and P1 when it is working at some other head also now, corresponding to some other head H1 now. I can obtain Q1, N1, P1 at some other head H1 now. So what should be this one? That is possible now. So that is the advantage of understanding the performance of the turbine. How it is, let us see it now. For example, QU, NU, PU will be same for both heads. QU, NU, PU will be same for both heads. That means if it is working at H1 or if it is working at H2, QU, NU, PU will be same only because it is working at the unit head we are saying now. We have QU is equal to Q by root H, that we know it now. That is equal to Q1 by root H1 now. So you can get the value of Q1. Q1 is equal to Q into root H1 divided by root H. Yes, you can obtain now. That is possible now. Because Q is equal to Q by root H now. That is equal to Q1 by root H. So Q1, if you want, I know what is Q, N and H, Q and N, P at a particular value H, I know it now. I want to obtain Q1, N1, P1 at particular value H1 I want now. I know this relation QU is equal to Q by root H now. That is the unit, this one. So this can also be written Q1 by root H1. Therefore, this is equal to this one. I can write Q1 is equal to Q into root H1 divided by H. So this is possible now, very important. I can predict the discharge requirement for different head when I know the discharge requirement for certain head. I know discharge requirement for certain head. Then I know I can obtain the discharge requirement for the different head. Same thing for this also. Nu is equal to n by root h, I know it now. So n1 is equal to n into nu is equal to n by root h. Therefore, that should be nu should also be equal to n1 by root h1, because our definition is that one now. Okay. So therefore, n1 is equal to n root h1 divided by root h. That is possible now. I can obtain the speed at which the turbine will rotate for different the value of h1. For this value of h1, what will be the speed of the turbine? I can predict. That is possible. Similarly, what will be the power developed? If I know at certain condition, these are the values, I know it means, I can obtain the power, that is Pu is equal to P by H to the power of 3 by 2, I know it now. That is equal to P1 by H to the power of 3 by 2. Therefore, P1, I can predict at P1, that is equal to P into H to the power of 3 by 2 divided by H1 to the power of 3 by 2 divided by H to the power of 3 by 2. That is the advantage of studying the unit quantities. That is the advantage of studying the unit quantities. However, these problems are not there. Only the theoretical. So that means when I know QNP, that is the discharge speed and power at a particular head, then I can predict the performance of the turbine for different heads. For example, I know for 10 meter head, this is the discharge I am having, this is the speed, this is the power I am having. If it works at 20 meter, I want to find Q, N and P, means yes, it is possible by means of knowing these formulas or by using the similarity equation which we have derived from the unit quantities. So that is the advantage, that's what we have written now. Advantage of obtaining the performance at unit head is that from a known value of discharge, speed and power of a turbine working under head H, the value of Q1, N1, P1 corresponding to some other values of H1 may be computed. That means I require to know these quantities. When I know these quantities, the other quantities can be obtained. So that is about the performance. Once again, you don't have the theory, the problems on this. The above derived expressions are based on the assumptions that efficiencies remains constant. That is very important, I have told you, at all heads. This is the efficiencies remain constant at all heads. Very important point here now. Then only I can compare the two velocity triangle. Assuming the efficiencies remain constant, it may not be so. When it works at different speed, the efficiencies may change. But here I have assumed that the efficiencies are constant. That is the assumption which may not be correct now, because the mechanical losses will be different and the leakage loss will be there. You know it, all these things when it goes. Now the clearance loss will be there in the reaction turbine. So efficiencies will not be same when it is working at different discharges or when it is working at different speeds. But here, from the theoretical point of view, I have assumed that the efficiencies remain same. If the efficiencies remain same only, then the velocity triangles can be compared, number one. Number two is, the head is always constant. Head is equal to 1 meter. We have defined. That is what unit quantities, when we have defined, head is equal to 1 meter, we have defined. The expressions for various quantities as derived above can be used for comparing the performance of any one turbine only. That is another important now. I am having two Francis turbine. I want to compare this means no. Only one turbine I can combine. Only under different conditions of operation. I know QNP of this one at particular head. then I can get Q1, N1 and P1 of this. They may be of different same company, they may be of same specification, but this two reaction turbines cannot be compared. Only one, the expression for various quantities can be above comparing the performance any one turbine only under different conditions. The same Kaplan and Francis cannot be compared. This is one, this one. Now the second thing what you are told is the Kaplan turbine only. If you are having two Kaplan turbine, you want to compare, means no, it is not possible. So only this turbine can be compared for different discharge or different head, for different heads. That should be properly understood now. Efficiency remains constant for different head. This is first assumption. Second thing is only single turbine, the same turbine can be compared for the performance. That should be there now. Very, very important points should be understood when you are looking at the unit quantities. So with this, we'll stop discussion on unit quantities also. Thank you very much. We shall go for the centrifugal pump in the next class. Thank you.